My first memory, actually, or one of my earliest memories, was riding on the back of my dad's trials bike, because he was a trials rider, and he had a Fantic motor. And I was riding on the back of it, and I don't think I was even wearing a helmet, but maybe I was. And I fell off, and my leg got stuck in the wheel, and my dad said, "Don't tell your mum, or you'll never be allowed to go on this again." So, sorry about that, mum. Now you know. For years I was wearing an old Moto 3 helmet until I realized that actually I wanted to ensure that if I crashed I had a chance of surviving, and wearing a helmet from 1972, as cool as it looked, I realized I was being a bit foolish. I don't want to be seen as a sort of revivalist of those things. I want to do it in a more of a contemporary manner, and whatever sort of suits my style, and using old techniques but modernizing the design slightly. Something like Oscar, that has been around for a while and is actually making incredible product that actually has armor in it. That's the thing that kind of bugs me quite a lot, is that the pieces have to be functional but look good as well. So it's kind of, I guess that's why I'm into the Oscar stuff. As soon as you start talking about motorcycles, it sounds like a cliche, but it really was an escape from work. And I wasn't overly conscious about trying to make my job solely to do with motorcycles. I use them as transportation. I get irritated by people who have extremely loud exhausts when they ride past me in the traffic. And I look at motorbikes a lot on the internet. I'd also like to just put it down on record that I'm not Australian, but when you look at the trial stuff and enduro as well, like the skill level involved in those guys is far superior. No, I shouldn't say far superior. It's a different level of commitment to learn how to ride a motorcycle like that. And it's not so much about being just completely balls out. It's a lot more to do with working out your balance and control and understanding the machine. And I feel like when you work with limitations like that, it actually helps you become a little bit more creative. I've always used a very limited palette. Like, this is a good idea of my color palettes. Pink and blue, green. Actually, green only came in since I moved to Los Angeles, because I saw all the palm trees with the blue sky and I thought they worked really well. But prior to that, it was always just pink and blue, grey and black and stuff. Freedom is very hard to use without it sounding like a really big cliche, especially when associated to motorcycles. So, freedom earned from throttles turned. I think it has a slight element of tongue-in-cheek humour, but at the same time it does represent the freedom you get from riding a motorcycle.